Now that we've positioned our bracket, you might recall that our speaker cone is actually floating out in space. It is not locked down. The center axis of it happens to be coincident with the center axis of our subwoofer, and that's good. But the transducer still has 2 degrees of freedom. It can slide in and out, and it can rotate axially. And so we need to be able to lock those two things down. And that's going to be relatively straightforward to do. First of all, actually, before we do anything here, I'm finding it a little bit difficult to see what's going on with my transducer because of all the pretty colors on it. So I'm actually going to override those really quickly, and then we can turn that back off later to get the pretty colors back if we want. So right up here at the top of my Feature Manager design tree, I have a display pane that I can show and hide, as we've talked about before. And there is an Appearances column right underneath that. Let's grab our 8-inch sub, click and click Appearance, and then we can apply any appearance that we want at the component level. And down here, I'm just going to choose a nice bright yellow color. We'll go to the Advanced tab under Illumination, and I'm going to turn my reflection amount way, way down to almost nothing, and hit OK, so that now we can see a little bit better what's going on. It's just a little bit less visually confusing what's going on the screen. Also, let's go ahead and hide, not the whole component, let's show the bracket component, but hide the surface body underneath that, so that we can just see the purple bracket there. It's just a little easier to see. Now let's go to our mating tool, and I'm going to mate the innermost face of this foam, this mounting foam on the back of our speaker bracket, to the outermost face of our purple bracket, and hit OK. So that'll lock that into place. And we can exit the mate tool, and now it's just going to rotate axially. It can no longer move in and out. We just rotate right around the axis, and that's good. Next, we need to define the axial position of this. So let's click on this face here, one of the faces of this bracket itself. Find that cage part, and underneath that I want to find the actual planes that define the orientation of that part. I'll grab the right plane of that cage. This is a part called 8-cage. We'll grab our mating tool, and I want to mate that to the right plane of our assembly. And it gave me an error by default, but if I click on coincident, it'll make those two coincident, which is just what I want. So now, we hit OK, and this thing is fully locked down. It says the selected component is fully defined, it cannot be moved, which is perfect. That's exactly what we want. We have a fully defined speaker cone in place. Now, to add the holes in our bracket, we're just going to need to figure out where those holes should go. So let's do that in the next video.